ओके, लेट्स सी मेजरमेंट ऑफ प्रेशर यूजिंग पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक क्रिस्टल. द ऑब्जेक्टिव इज टू शो यू द वर्किंग ऑफ पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक क्रिस्टल. सो इट इज़ यूज टू मेजर प्रेशर. सो पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक इफेक्ट इज द वन इन विच चेंजेस आर इंड्यूस्ड अक्रॉस द सर्टेन सर्फेस ऑफ द क्रिस्टल्स वेन इट्स मैकेनिकल डायमेंशंस आर चेंज ड्यू टू द एप्लीकेशन ऑफ प्रेशर. सो दीज यू कैन सी आर पीजोइलेक्ट्रिक क्रिस्टल्स. इफ यू अप्लाई द प्रेशर there will be a change in their mechanical dimensions and which will produce charges. Okay, that's the piezoelectric effect, and it's a reversible process. Means if you apply the voltage across it, there will be change in the mechanical dimensions, so that we will deal later. So it's a reversible process, and the materials which reflect this property are quartz crystal, Roche salt and barium titanate. Okay, these are the crystals where you observe this piezoelectric effect property, and there if you apply force you will get charges or voltages across it. So this is one of the way to measure pressure using piezoelectric crystal. These crystals are called as piezoelectric, okay, and this property is called as piezoelectric effect. So now if you have this as your piezoelectric crystal, if you apply force, certain voltage will be or you can say charge will be appear across the terminals of crystals. So Q can be proportional to force applied. Q is the charge. If you remove the proportionality constant, you will get Q is equal to df, where d is charge sensitivity. If you consider it as a parallel plate capacitor, your Q will be C into V. With respect to our scenario, Q will be equal to Cp into E naught. E naught is the voltage and Cp is the capacitance between the plates. If you plug the value of Q here, you will get Cp E naught is equal to Df. Put the formula of Cp, that is epsilon A divided by T, where A is the area between the plates and T is the distance between the plates. Epsilon is the permittivity inside between the plates. So if you calculate the value of E naught, you will get E naught is equal to dFT divided by epsilon A. Now F upon A will be called as pressure. D upon epsilon will be called as G, which is something called voltage sensitivity. So if you plug the value of G and P, you will get E naught is equal to G into P into T. This is the expression mostly used in piezoelectric crystals to find the output voltage. Okay, so it depends upon G, P and T. Now G and T are constants. G and T are constants. So E naught will be proportional to P. So you can see, if you change the pressure, the output will be changed. Output voltage. Okay, where G is D upon epsilon, voltage sensitivity. P is pressure, F upon A, and T is the distance, or you can say thickness between the plates. Okay. So that is how you derive it, where D is charge sensitivity. This thing one you should remember, okay, which removes the proportionality constant. So this is how you measure pressure using piezoelectric crystal. The main drawback of this method is it is only used to measure dynamic pressures. Okay, if you have a static pressure like this, it will not measure. So it requires dynamic change or dynamic pressure across it to be measured. Okay. So this is one of the biggest drawback of this method. So the objective is to show you how piezoelectric crystals work, okay, and to show you this expression as well. Sometimes this is used in numerical a lot of time. Okay, let's see an example on piezoelectric transducer. So a quartz piezoelectric transducer 0.5 cm square in area and 1 mm thick is connected to a charge amplifier having feedback capacitor of 30 picofarad. The Coulomb sensitivity of transducer is 2 picocoulomb per newton. This is also charge sensitivity, okay, since it is picocoulomb divided by newton. Sinusoidal force of 30 into 10 to the power minus 3 sine 150 t newton is applied on the transducer. What is the peak to peak voltage at the amplifier output? So this is your transducer, this is your charge amplifier, and this is capacitor. Current is flowing IT through this branch. So you have to find the peak to peak value of V naught. Okay. So let's look at the solution. So the current flowing through this branch will be equal to dq divided by dt. Q is the charge appeared across this transducer, which can be written as d into ft. D is constant, which is charge sensitivity. You can take it out. Ft is pressure, which is dependent upon time. So d by dt of ft. Now this is one part current, and the voltage across capacitor can be written as V naught is equal to minus 1 by C integration minus infinity to t it. This current will be flowing in this branch as well. So now if you plug the value of it, what you will get? V naught is equal to minus 1 by C d f of t. This differentiation will be cancelled out by this integration. Rest everything is same. Now if you plug the value of C, that is epsilon A by T, your V naught will be minus dt divided by epsilon naught A ft. You can see the V naught is proportional to ft because rest everything is constant. Now you need peak to peak value. For that you will need maximum value at the output. So maximum you will get when ft will be minimum, since it is a negative sign is there. So what I can write is, I can take ft maximum and I can remove minus sign. So V naught will be dt ft max divided by epsilon naught A. And since you need a peak to peak value, you can multiply with the 2. So basically what you will calculate is Vp is equal to 2 into dt ft max divided by epsilon naught A. I removed this negative sign and I wrote maximum. That will be the same thing. Okay. In that case also you will get V naught maximum. So if you plug the value of d t f t epsilon naught A, you will get the peak to peak value. That's what we will do. So now if you plug the values, you will get V peak to peak, that is 2 into d is 2 pico coulomb per newton, so 2 into 10 to the power minus 12 into 30 into 10 to the power minus 3, that is maximum value of force, 30 into 10 to the power minus 3, divided by epsilon naught A. Epsilon naught is 8.85 into 10 to the power minus 12 into 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 4, that is area 0.5, and 10 to the power minus 4 to convert it into meter square. Okay. If you solve this, you will get 0.2712 volt is your peak to peak value of this output. Okay. Okay, I forgot to mention this T part. T is also 1 into 10 to the power minus 3 in meters. So once you plug the value, you will get 0.2712 volt. Okay. Okay, let's see next question. So it is given that the charge sensitivity of a piezoelectric transducer is 40 picocoulomb per newton. A charge amplifier is connected with piezoelectric transducer such that the combination of transducer and amplifier is having overall gain of 100 millivolt per newton. You have to find first the gain of the amplifier and second the value of feedback capacitance. So this is the amplifier part, this is your transducer. You have to find the value of capacitor and you have to find the value of amplifier gain. Overall gain is given as 100 millivolt per newton and the charge sensitivity D is given as 40 picocoulomb per newton. Okay, so let's first calculate the overall gain. So amplifier gain. So amplifier gain can be calculated by this relation. Overall gain is equal to amplifier gain into charge sensitivity. Overall gain is given as 100 millivolt per newton. Amplifier gain into charge sensitivity, that is 40 picocoulomb per newton. And with this, amplifier gain can be calculated as 2.5 millivolt per picocoulomb. So this relation might seem awkward to you. So I'll show you. This overall gain is the gain between this V naught and the pressure applying you are applying to the transducer. That is why it is in millivolt per newton. Okay, whatever the force you are applying at the input of transducer. Okay. So that is why it is newton, and at the output you have V naught, that is in volts, that is why millivolt per newton. That is the overall gain. Now, once you got amplifier gain, you can see it's in millivolt per picocoulomb. So millivolt because then at the output you have voltage, and picocoulomb at the input because you have a charge. Okay, that is why it is charge amplifier. It is amplifying charge. So I hope you got the relation. So that is how you use the charge sensitivity. So picocoulomb will be here, millivolt will be here, newton will get cancelled. So millivolt per picocoulomb. Okay, so this will be your amplifier gain. So amplifier gain, overall gain is 100 millivolt per newton, overall gain, amplifier gain, and you use charge sensitivity to calculate this. Okay, so let's see the second part. So you have IT is equal to dQ by dt. Q can be written as charge sensitivity into force. So charge sensitivity is constant, so that is why d came out. T by dt of ft, that is force. Okay, v0 is equal to minus 1 by c minus infinity to t it dt, that is the current across this capacitor, this it, and voltage will be voltage across this capacitor, and the same current will be flowing in this branch as well. This is this current, and q is equal to d into ft, came from the transducer. Okay, f is force and d is charge sensitivity. So if you plug the value of it here, this integration will go removed, minus 1 by c d of ft. Okay, d of ft, this is what you will get. Now v0 by ft will be overall gain. This is what you can see, v0 is output, ft is the force applied to the transducer. That is why I can write v0 divided by ft is equal to minus d by c, and since you are using mod, that is why I removed minus sign. Okay, I've just manipulated this. Now I can use this relation of overall gain. This means 100 millivolt per newton is equal to d is charge sensitivity, 40 picocoulomb per newton divided by c. From here you can calculate c is equal to 400 picofarad. So I hope you saw how I used the relation, this relation. So v0 divided by ft, it is what minus d by c was. So I took the modulus because I need to calculate the value of c. Okay, so modulus removed the minus sign, and then I use the relation values to calculate the value of c. So c is your 400 picofarad. Okay, next question. So the diaphragms of pressure measuring transducer are 2.5 centimeter square in area and are 3 millimeter apart. A pressure of 10 to the power 4 newton per meter square produces a deflection of 0.3 mm of a diaphragm. Without any pressure, the capacitance is 300 picofarad. Determine the capacitance after a pressure of 10 to the power 4 newton per meter square is applied. Okay, let's look at the solution. So the capacitance, you know, it is related to the distance between the plates is C epsilon naught A by D. So C is inversely related to D, you can see. So C1 divided by C2, I can write D2 divided by D1. Let's say C2 is the capacitance when you have applied the pressure, and C1 is the capacitance when you have not applied the pressure. So you can plug the values. C1 is 300 picofarad without any pressure. At that time, you have a distance between the plates say is 3 mm. When you applied the pressure, your capacitance is C2, that is what you have to calculate. And the deflection produced was 0.33 mm, means from total it is minus 0.3 mm. Okay, so this is the catch point. So you had 3 mm, you applied the force, it the deflection produced was 0.33. So from 3, you have subtracted 0.33. Okay. This is in mm, mm will get cancelled. So C2 you can calculate as 3 divided by 2.7 into 300 picofarad. That is 333.33 picofarad. That is the capacitance when you have applied the pressure of 10 to the power 4 newton per meter square. Okay.